ladies and gentlemen and children of all ages. We're going to present for your approval a novelty picture with an all-midget cast, the first of its kind ever to be produced. I'm told that it has everything. That is, everything that a Western should have. It's a soul-stirring drama, a searing saga of the sagebrush, and it's called The Terror of Tiny Town. But I must caution you not to take it too seriously. This picture begins...
Hey, mister, come down here. I want to talk to you.
Pardon me. Excuse me, there's a slight correction. You mean it is serious?
Sure it's serious. I'm the hero. After this picture's out, I'll be the biggest cowboy star in Hollywood.
Wait a minute. The star in Hollywood.
Who are you? Well, who are you?
I'm the villain. Who did that? The applause is okay. But who laughed? I'm the toughest hombre that ever threw lead. And I ain't afraid of the biggest one of you. I'm the terror of Tiny Town. And that's the star part.
That's what you think.
Yeah, that's just what I think.
Oh, wait a minute. Man, wait a minute.
We'll see. Let's go through the picture.
That's a swell idea. Let's go through with the picture.
Chirping out of your system. Maybe you could get back to the ranch.
Sure, Dad. I'm riding back right away.
I want you to go up to North Fork Range, see what's wrong up there.
What do you think's wrong?
I don't know. I was up through there the other day, and there ain't hardly a calf on the range. And I don't think cows have quit having families.
Maybe mountain lion's been getting them?
I didn't see any lion tracks.
Well, I'll scout around and see what I can find out.
Before we have visitors. Here comes Buck Lawson. Hit leather. Leave that iron. I want Buck Lawson to fight.
That's been getting away with our calves. I jumped a bunch of rustlers at work.
Rustlers?
And they left in such a hurry they forgot their branding iron.
T-Bar-P, Tex Preston.
That's the way I read it.
Why, that low-down coyote. I fought Tex Preston to a standstill 15 years ago, and it looks like he ain't learned his lesson.
That branding iron fixed things with the Lawson outfit. Now we'll throw a scare at Tex Preston. You boys know what to do. Stay here and watch for my signal. How's everything?
Things are not so good. Seems like I'm losing stock lately.
When I was riding over this way, I found a cow of yours laying in the brush. She'd been shot.
What? Someone killing my stock?
It looks that way. There was a calf hanging around. Looked like he was related to her. But he carried Pop Lawson's brand.
Well, a low-down coyote. Killing my cows so he can steal my calves. Why, I fought Pop Lawson to a standstill 15 years ago. You think he'd know better than the monkey with a buzzsaw?
Mr. Preston, I think to myself, you're tired to eat beef, so I cook you a nice duck. Oh, boy, she looks beautiful in the frying pan.
This comes from our brass duck.
Looks to me like somebody ain't very friendly.
I've got a pretty good idea who did it. No one ever asked me for a fight without finding me willing to oblige.
Mr. Preston, I think for myself again, you have to eat beef. Fritz, Fritz, doggy, doggy, listen, doggy. Doggy, doggy. Fritz, come here, Fritz. Come here, ducky. Nice, nice call. So go away, I don't want you. Go away, go away, go away. Come here. I won't hurt you. I won't hurt you. Come here. For goodness sake, can we not sit down somewhere and talk things over? Oh, dear, come here, Fritz. Here. Look at a nice corn. I can eat myself. Come here. I won't hurt you, Fritz. Come here. Ducky, ducky. Wait for me. Come here, ducky. Come here. Come here. I just want to make friends with you. Look, Fritz. I'm getting late for the boss's dinner, and I'm getting tired. Fritz, I want
only need you for 1 minute. Fritzy, Fritzy, come out. I got something for you. I got something nice for you. Fritzy, you around your son, Blizz. Enjoy yourself while we're waiting for the stage.
As I was saying, I never thought that Mrs. Clancy could be so small.
You're absolutely right. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye. Good morning, Mr. Johnson.
Good morning.
Howdy, Tex.
Hello, Sheriff.
I'm warning you, Tex. Don't start no trouble in town.
I won't hunt no trouble, and I won't run away from it either.
Buck, there's no sense of all you boys riding to town. You scout around and keep an eye out for rustlers.
But you might meet up with that Preston outfit.
If I do, I reckon I can take care of myself. I don't need someone to ride herd on me.
All right, Dad. We'll head back.
Now, don't forget what I told you.
Come on, Arrow, let's get those supplies.
Hello, Tex. What are you doing in town?
My niece comes in on the stage today.
Your niece, huh? Coming out for a visit?
No, she's going to make a home with me. Her folks died, and I'm all the kin she's got.
She's not coming to a very peaceful spot.
Oh, it'll be peaceful, all right, when I do some exterminating that needs to be done around here.
And you're just the man that can do it.
Don't worry, we will do it. Come on.
Preston outfits. Let nature take its course.
It's my duty to keep peace.
Your duty, if you're smart, is to do as I tell you. I'm grabbing myself a nice bunch of cattle from both sides, and each one blames the other. I'll finally land up owning both outfits.
You better look out.
For the bank.
Is it coming in on the stage?
I've stood for rustling and a lot of dirty work, but holding up the stage might mean murder. That's going too far.
If you don't like my game, just say so. The warden at the penitentiary would just love to see you come back and finish your time.
When a man wants to go straight, why won't you give him a chance?
Cry about that some other time. What about that money?
It's due to arrive on this stage.
Now you're talking sense. Beat it.
Well, Beth, how's everything working out?
Great, Nita. I'll sure keep my promise and load you down with diamonds.
I can carry the weight.
Bartender, my private bottle.
Yes, sir. Coming up.
Will you be in town for a while?
No, I got a little job to do.
The one I told you about?
Yeah. I just got some information about it. I'll see you when I get back.
Be careful, will you?
Don't worry about me. Well, you big ox, what are you trying to do?
I can't help it, boss. I schlitzed.
Well, schlitz that stuff into the wagon. I'm going over to the barber shop and get schlitz cleaned up.
Good. That's all right, Mrs. Barber shop. What kind of skills are you trying to get? Yes, garlic.
I don't want to scare my niece by looking like an outlaw.
I make you look like a Beau Brummer.
Oh, you needn't go as far as that. Don't strain yourself.
Anybody in town got any calves? They better watch them today.
I thought the county paid a bounty on coyotes instead of letting them run around loose.
Seems to me I smell something that should be buried. It smells mighty like a polecat.
Why, you?
I won't get shaved here today. I might catch smallpox.
On. Let's pick up their trail and see what they're up to. Are you all right, miss?
I'm nearly frying to death, but otherwise all right, thanks to you.
You had a right to be scared. Nobody would have found that ride a pleasure trip.
Why, it's outrageous that a respectable citizen should be endangered like that. I'll see that something is done to put a stop to it.
That's the way for a man to talk. I'll have the sheriff take you along when he goes after those outlaws. He needs more men like you. Lend me a hand with those fellas on top, and we'll take the stage on in. Someone will hang for this job. Pete in there was a good man and a good friend of mine. Maybe you'd rather ride on top with me.
Yes, I would if you don't mind.
I'm proud to have your company. Hey, cowboy, climb aboard or we're gonna leave you. Hurry up!
rich home, Count Buck Lawson. Do we stand for that?
What do you think?
I think we should send Babyface after him.
Sure, boss. I'll make smoked beef out of him.
Shut up. Take it easy, Babyface. He'll get his. Only we'll do it the smart way. We'll have those two outfits killing each other. It's about time we run off another bunch of stock. Don't you see the dynamite, you local maverick? I hear the stage was held up today, Sheriff.
They didn't get anything, but they killed Pete and the Wells Fargo messenger.
That's too bad.
Sheriff, outlaws have been mighty busy around here of late, and I can't see where you've done much about it.
You better not prod the sheriff, Buck. He might take an interest in all that gun smoke out your way. That ain't just according to law.
Why, wait a minute, Buck.
You're wrong, Bat. Any man's got a right to protect himself.
What's the matter, Nancy? Forget something?
Oh, no. I was just looking around.
Oh, well, there ain't much to see in this town. We better get going.
All right, Uncle Jim. But it seems like I should say something to the man that stopped the runaway.
The least you have to say to him, why, the better.
All right, boys, we'll get started. Buck, how about riding with the posse?
I got an idea I'd be wasting my time.
Meaning anything in particular?
No. It just seems that you don't have any luck when you go hunting outlaws. Dad, don't you think we'd better get back to the ranch?
All right. I don't admire that remark Buck Lawson made.
He's too smart for his own good. I'm taking him out of circulation before long.
Boss, we ain't been able to round up enough prime beef to make it worthwhile sending a trail herd to the railroad.
I bet I can thank Pop Lawson for that. And the sheriff must be on his side. Why, I'm being rustled poor and can get no help from the law.
You better do something about it pretty pronto.
I'll do plenty. Put on more hands, but get men that can sling guns. I'll stop it.
I'll ride into town and see what gunfighters I can locate.
All right.
Love your troubles away. Love your troubles away.
Just thinking, what a fine world this would be if there weren't some Lawsons in it.
I think it's a pretty nice place just as it is. And I'm sure you're the nicest uncle in the world.
Going for a ride again today?
You don't mind, do you?
Why, bless your heart, no. Go on, enjoy yourself.
Would you put up a lunch for me?
What would you like to eat?
Oh, a half a dozen sandwiches, some boiled eggs and pickles.
Where are you going to put all that?
In my saddlebag.
In your saddlebag. And then where are you going to put it?
In my tummy.
In your tummy. Little girl like you, every day she gets more appetite.
Well, I get terribly hungry when I ride.
Yeah, I know. It's the exercise. Maybe you want 2 pieces of cake like yesterday.
Yes, 2 pieces. You make such wonderful cake.
I know.
Thank you. cowboys' hearts are lonely, sad as a coyote's wail. But I am never lonely when you and I hit the trail. For I'll sing my song as we ride along down on the sunset trail, with the stars to it while we're side by side, down on the sunset trail. The road is long and weary, but our hearts are strong and cheery, and I'll sing a while as we count each mile down on the sunset trail.
Let's go way up on the hill. Pretend you're Jack and I'm Jill. Instead of tumbling down into town, we'll go round talking of love. When we get up on the hill, where all is quiet and still, instead of tumbling down into town, we'll go round talking of love. Bluebirds are singing on high while we're together. Dark clouds are all rolling by, we're in for sunny weather. And you'll be my Mr. Jack, and I'll be your Mrs. Jill. The crowd will congregate, celebrate the wedding of Jack and Jill.
Say, that was mighty pretty. Why didn't you tell me before this that you could really sing?
Can I?
The best I've ever heard.
Liar.
Honest, was that song for me?
Well, there's nobody else around. Did you really like it?
Why, certainly. That is, all but the finish. The part about the wedding?
Oh, I see. A woman hater. Don't you ever think of settling down?
Not until I stop this feud between our families.
I hope you can, Buck. Soon.
Oh, let's forget all this trouble and just go on with our picnic.
Wait a minute, Buck. I'm trespassing on the Lawson Range. Aren't you going to throw me off?
Well, not until after we've had this lunch.
Oh, is that the only reason why I'm welcomed? Just because I feed you?
I'm not saying it is, and I'm not saying it isn't.
In other words, you don't believe in taking chances. Well, come on. I'll feed you anyway.
A range war is like rolling a rock down the mountain. Easy to stop, but mighty hard to stop.
But you don't hate me, and I don't hate you. Why can't we be allowed to live in peace? We have the right to be happy.
We could have all that if only we could make folks use common sense instead of gun smoke.
Ooh, I better get back to the ranch. I've tried to reason with Uncle Jim, but it only makes him angry. He just won't listen to me.
We still can be friends, in spite of everything.
Just friends?
But there's a very serious matter I want to talk to you about just as soon as I get this trouble ironed out.
I'll be waiting.
Is this the way you ride the line? Ballygagging with one of the Preston breed?
Dad, she has nothing to do with the quarrel between you and Tex Preston.
She's of the same breed, and man or woman, I won't have one of them on my range.
Dad, I don't take that kind of talk about my friends.
Please, Buck, don't quarrel with your father on my account.
If there's any quarrel, it's of his makings. Dad, if you're calling for a showdown, I'm standing pat.
If you favor my enemies, you're not my son.
With your father. I can't come between you.
We'll work this out somehow. I'll make those two old war horses understand some common sense. If you don't mind, I'll ride a ways with you.
All right.
I think they're headed for town.
What? I'll put a stop to that. Just as fast as you can. I don't allow no Larsons on my ranch. Get before I make a sieve on you.
Uncle Jim, please.
Do as he says. There won't be any trouble.
You promise?
I promise.
Now you make tracks and make them prompt.
You're not afraid to shoot it out with me, are you?
No, I'm not.
I dare you to talk to me for 5 minutes.
Why, I never took a dare in my life. Come on. Come on, start talking and make it fast.
Tex, you think our outfit rustled your stock. I know you're wrong.
Well, I've lost plenty of stock.
So have we. Are you rustling from us?
I am not.
Hold on, Preston. You agreed to talk for 5 minutes.
Well, all right.
We're both losing stock. You blame us, and we blame you. That don't make sense. Doesn't it strike you as being reasonable that someone is playing us against each other and rustling from both? If you and Dad would stop this fool war and work together, we might find out who it is.
Even if I was willing. It takes two men to stop a war.
If you'd only meet Dad halfway, I know he'd be reasonable.
Buck, you sound honest to me, and I believe you're talking horse sense.
I'm glad you see it my way, Tex. I'll make Dad wash off the war paint and meet you in town for a powwow. Will you be there?
Sure.
So long, Tex.
So long, Buck.
Thank you.
just killed Tex Preston over on the South Pass. Shot him in the back.
Hit leather, ma'am, and shoot on sight.
I'm sorry, Nancy.
How could he do a thing like that?
You can't tell what a man might do in the heat of anger. You can count on me to do all I can for you.
For so long.
Don't bother me, I'm busy.
Sheriff, I got a job for you.
Yeah, I reckon it won't be anything I can be proud of. What is it?
I want you to arrest Buck Lawson for the murder of Tex Preston.
Hey, 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 hey.
I hear you've been showing a lot of interest in that Preston girl.
What I do is my own business.
Oh, like that, eh?
Yeah, just like that.
That's where you're wrong. You owe me plenty. And don't get the idea you can kick me off like an old shoe.
What do you do about it?
Stick around. You'll find out.
I'm so sorry, Nancy.
What do you mean? What have I done?
Don't pretend. That Haynes said you shot my uncle.
He lied. Nancy, you can't believe that.
Oh, I don't know what to believe. I left you talking to Uncle Jim, and now he's dead.
That's what I came to tell you. Only two people knew that Jim Preston was killed. Myself and the man who shot him. Bat Haynes and I are due for a talk. Talk to you.
Hold on, Buck. I'm arresting you for murder.
And who say so?
Bat Haynes. Hold on, Bat. This man is in the custody of the law. I'll take those shooting irons.
We both know who killed Tex Preston.
Yeah, but I know who's gonna hang for it.
Don't bank on that too heavy.
Get going.
If we could stop this rustling, we'd pull out of the hole all right. But there's no chance to raise any money right now.
Thank you. That's all I wanted to know.
Yes. Your uncle was talking about taking on some more gunfighters. I've located three or four.
No, I'll have no more bloodshed.
Yes.
I think Buck Haynes is a snake in the grass.
Snake or no snake, he'll be boss around here pretty pronto.
Oh, yeah, boss around here. Don't forget, I'm the cook. I fix him.
Why try to run a cow ranch? That's no job for a woman. Now, as my wife...
No, that's out of the question.
What's the matter with me as a husband? Why, someday I'll be the biggest man in this county.
That has nothing to do with it.
Still hankering for that half pint that murdered your uncle, eh?
I don't believe he did it.
You mean I lied?
When two men tell a different story, one of them lies.
All right, I try to be friends, and for thanks, I get slapped in the face. Your uncle owed me a lot of money. You better be ready to pay it up.
You know I can't right now.
That's your worry.
Thanks, Otto.
I hope you get stomach trouble.
Otto, how many times have I told you not to eat so much pie? Do you want to get sick?
I feel all right.
Hurry up and get ready. I want you to ride to town with me.
Okay, okay.
You look worried.
What makes you think so?
Well, just the way you've been acting.
Don't
pay so much attention to me.
Maybe the sheriff takes orders from you, but no jury will convict him if she's on his side.
Maybe we won't have a jury.
Nancy, it was mighty nice of you to drop in and see if they're taking good care of me.
I'm sorry. Is there anything I can do to help you?
There's nothing to worry about. They can't convict me of something I never did.
That Hayes is buying a drink. Everybody chin up to the bar.
Hey, hey.
To take Buck over to the gambling house and hang him.
Who is?
The whole town, I guess.
Let him go and give him a chance to save himself.
I can't turn a prisoner loose.
Would you keep him here to be murdered?
They won't try anything like that.
If I had a couple of the boys from Dad's ranch, I'd give them a run for their money.
You'll have them.
What about the sheriff? He might object.
Oh, he'll be reasonable. Come on, let's get going.
Yeah.
What if I told this scout what I know about you?
Forget there's a law in this town.
That's all right, Sheriff. We figure to save you some bother. Come on, man.
Hurry or you'll be too late.
Who?
Get the boys. We're riding to town.
You're back in this, Haynes. You're not man enough to fight it out with me.
Why bother? This suits me all right.
Urges you to be strung up until you are dead.
Hold on, men. Buck Lawson is innocent. It was Bat Haynes who...
There we are! From now on, I'm playing a lone hand.
Take care of him, Dad. I got a job to do.
Drop those gun belts and be careful how you do it. Are you hurt bad, Sheriff?
It looks like I'm at the end of my trail. Haynes did all the rustling and caused all the trouble between you and Tex Preston. And Nita was in with him. You find him in a cabin in Big Rock Canyon.
Hoot, round up all the boys. We're heading for Big Rock Canyon.
Give you an even break. That's more than you did for me. But what happened?
You just missed being an angel by about 3 seconds.
I think he's somewhat of an angel right now. What is this important matter you wanted to talk to me about?
That's right, I forgot.
Wait a minute.
now.
And I'll be your mistress.